I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Have you met Nick and Nate Diaz yet?
I have.
What's that like? They're one of the coolest people, some of the coolest people you'll meet.
Yeah, they're very cool. You know, I mean, they're from my city, Southern California.
209.
209.
Who do you want to see Nate fight next?
Nate, McGregor, you know. It's tied right now. I think
it's 2-0 and Nate got robbed in the second one.
Oh, yeah. I'll say that too, but in the books, it's tied right now. That's 1-1, so I want Nate to get his get back. And, you know, it's more money.
You know, I always said that Nate would give Floyd Mayweather a better fight than Conor did, because Nate has better boxing. You ever box with them? Or, I mean, you're smaller physically, but...
I mean, think about it. McGregor is naturally a smaller guy. Nate's way, way bigger.
He is?
So, I'm pretty sure he'll give him a better fight, but... I don't think Mayweather would get in the ring with him because he's way too big.
Now, I asked your dad before. Stockton, California, one of the most dangerous places in California. You're now a boxing star. You're getting famous. Can you tell the way people treat you different now that you're becoming famous? Or?
I mean, I go to restaurants in my city, you know, and I eat for free sometimes. Sometimes they'll give me a free meal here and there, you know. And it's lovely. I like that they show the support back, and they're cool. I go away like 20 minutes away from Stockton, Manteca. And I go there, I go to a bowling alley because I like to bowl. And then a whole bunch of people come up to me, take pictures, I sign something here and there.
Are you a good bowler? You got skills?
Oh, I got skills, man.
Okay, you and Adrian Broner in a bowling game, who wins?
I haven't seen Adrian Broner, but me.
No, I went with him bowling, he doesn't lose.
He doesn't lose?
He doesn't. They give him the worst guy to be his teammate, he still wins. he has skills.
That's tight.
Who would you want to fight if you could line up 3 fights for you the next year? Anybody in the world?
I mean, right now, it's kind of irrelevant because I'm still building. You know, I'm still getting up there. When I'm about 19, 20, I'll get those big fights and hopefully get a world title by then. But right now, I'm just fighting anybody who top-ranked throws at me because right now I'm not in a position to be having big fights right now. So I don't really have any names in my mind.
All right, there you have to be where to follow you.
At @G_squad_nation on Instagram and Twitter, on Gabriel Flores on Facebook.
Stay tuned. If you're soon reporting, come by Sickback Reporting. What's up, Josecito? So your son's 5-0. What's next for him?
February 3rd, Corpus Christi.
Wow.
Yeah, he's on the ESPN card with Sordo Ramirez.
Uh-huh. It's a big card.
Right.
Your son's doing great. Already 5-0. The young 16 and a half signed by Top Rank.
Right, right.
What's the plan? When do you want to see him fight for a title? Do you want to do a record speed in 9 fights, 10 fights, or take his time?
Nah, man, I'm not trying to break no records. I'm trying to do the best thing for him. You know, Top Rank's obviously the best to do that, develop young fighters. So I've been somewhere around 20 years old, probably fight for a title.
And people want to follow him and follow you, where do they go?
At Coach G Flores, little G's at @G_Squad_Nation.
And who else do you work with? I see you have another fighter here at the gym right now.
Mikaela Mayer.
How long have you worked with her?
How long has it been?
From August.
And how's it going so far? Is it
good?
You know, she's going to get a lot of attention as the time. So is your son, both of them.
Right.
Are you ready for all the attention you're going to get?
I don't really pay attention to it. I mean, it's great if it comes, but I don't really pay attention. I stay focused on my job and our work.
Just to win.
Right.
And why do you love boxing, Coach?
I don't know, man. It's just the challenge, man. You know, beating the other person, you know, developing a game plan. You know? I mean, it's just the strategy part of it.
You know, of course, Stockton, and Robert was telling me this week, one of the most dangerous cities in America, number 1 in California, most killings.
Right.
What's it like to live over there? People ask me, what's it like to live in Stockton?
I mean, for the most part, it's kind of messed up, man. I grew up in gangs, you know, went to Hawaii when I was young, locked up most of my teenagers. Yeah. So, I mean, I didn't want that for my son, so I just put him in boxing, and here we are.
And now doing great, 5-0.
Yeah, right, yeah.
She's in the road to be a champion. 130, you know, 130 in the men division, they're all calling each other out.
Right.
There's a lot of beef in the 130 division. Gervonta Davis, Lomachenko, you have, I saw Devin Haney was calling someone out. I saw, who else do you have over there? Teofimo Lopez.
Right.
You have a lot of big fights.
And, we don't get caught up in all that, man. We just do our job and, you know, take it fight by fight.
Who's the best fighter in the world right now? Who's pound for pound king?
Terrence Crawford.
Why do you say that?
Because he's been on top for a long time. He's proven himself. I mean, since Andre's gone, I say Terrence. And, you know, Lomachenko's great also, but he's also 9-1.
Okay, if Crawford fights Errol Spence, Who do you like on that one?
I think it's a great fight. They both got dog in them. You know, Errol Spence, obviously, the dog, tearing his property, proves himself over and over. He's willing to, you know, do whatever it takes to win. So I think that's a great fight.
All right, there's the man of the hour. He still looks like a kid, though.
Yeah, he does. He is a kid, 17 years old.
Reporting.
Turn up the volume and just sit back. You rocking with the best, who? Elie Seckbach. The wave of the future, we don't lose. Tell me what you watching, EsNews. He came a long way, all the way from Jerusalem. Heavy on the grind, competition, he abusing them.